And ladies and gentlemen, we are here at Coleridge Field for the HBCU Classic hosted by the Atlanta Braves. We have the head coach for Grambling University, Grambling State University. Let people know your name and a little bit of your baseball background.
James Cooper. I'm from Cutherland, Louisiana. I attended Spring Hill High School. After Spring Hill High School, I attended Grambling State University. I was drafted by the Houston Astros organization, and I also played professional baseball in the Can-Am League with the Sussex, New Jersey. Up in Sussex, New Jersey with the Sussex Skyhawks. And I've been the head coach at Grambling State University for 12 seasons now.
Okay, tell us about this weekend's matchup. Give us a little bit about what are some things that you guys have prepared for to put yourself in a position not only to win today, but to win this series.
Well, we're going to be prepared to play an opponent from the MEAC Conference in FAMU who has a rich tradition in baseball. They also have a rich tradition in the Atlanta Braves organization as well as we do at Grambling State University. We know they're going to run out some tall pitchers that will be able to pound the strike zone with some really good fastballs. So we have to be on time for that. And we're just going to stick to our three fundamental keys, and that's that our pitchers must throw quality strikes, we must be solid on defense, and we have to make the routine play in a routine way. And last but not least, we have to be efficient at the plate and have timely hitting.
Tell us about, as part of your scouting, getting familiar with the layout of the ballpark, what are some things that you shared with your players to help them know, whether it's, the angles, things along those lines?
Well, we do a really good job of telling our guys that no two ballparks are going to play the same. No two ballparks' dimensions will be the same. You have some ballparks that have more foul territory than others. So you have to be aware of your surroundings with how much room you have on foul territory. Also, the layout of the land, like you mentioned, backstop paddings are different, as well as outfield fence paddings. So guys have to have an understanding of how balls might carry them versus off of a chain link in comparison to how it will carry them off of a padded fence or a wooded fence or defensively, but hopefully offensively, we can use it to get us extra bases.
Okay. The importance of a series like this, what does this mean for your university, and what do you think it means for HBCU baseball?
It means a lot. It's going to be something that we can't quantify over a period of time because of how many people will be able to view these two programs playing here at this facility. When you talk about how nice the facility is, that's going to be a feather in the cap to open up the eyes of this young black baseball player that wants to pursue a college degree at a HBCU like the two that's here, and also to better themselves as a baseball player. When you come to Grambling, these are some of the things you sign up for. We talk to our kids all the time about how we can get them a big league education and also a big league experience. When they graduate, they would have that big league education. But last but not least, all of them won't get a chance to play professional baseball, but with relationships like we have with the Atlanta Braves has provided us the opportunity to give them a big league experience by playing at a AAA ballpark for a weekend series. This is something that is unprecedented for Grambling as well as FAMU, but the relationships that both schools have with the Atlanta Braves and the powers that be behind the scenes have allowed us to be here today.
Last question. What message would you like to deliver for younger players, high school, middle school, even other college players who are really looking at pursuing baseball? What would be, of the many takeaways, what's one takeaway you'd like to leave with everybody?
Well, Grambling has done a lot for me. I attended my first big league game as a college baseball player at Grambling State, and it was to a Houston Astros game, not knowing that I would be drafted by the Houston Astros organization that same year. So that's very, near and dear to my heart and very sentimental. Fast forward, my grandfather was an Atlanta Braves fan, so I grew up an Atlanta Braves fan. So not only am I getting a chance to coach at a facility that's affiliated with the Atlanta Braves, I get a chance to get that experience for all of my players and all of my coaching staff. Like I mentioned before, some players might not get a chance to have a big league experience, but this might be the closest thing to it. Some of my coaches on my coaching staff might not get a chance to coach professional or coach at the big league level, but this will be the closest thing to it. So when you come to Grambling, you can go to anywhere after you leave here.
Tell you what, thank you so much for making the time. Best wishes on today, the weekend, and the rest of the season.
That's right. Go Grambling.